But as I've said before, the majority of the press are dedicated Democrats, not dedicated journalists.
And now, you know what? That's again, he's right there. The majority of the press are dedicated Democrats. I'll give him that, man. That's not socialism. That's not leftism. And it's all controlled op. It's all controlled opposition. The centrist, liberal, pro-capitalist, bourgeois press is framed by the right-wing media as being far left and fanatical and associated with actual leftists and anti-capitalist, communist, and anarchists, which it's not in any way whatsoever. And it demonizes that bourgeois, liberal, pro-capitalist media to such an extent with that, that there's people fear that centrist pro-capitalist talking point and ideology so much so that they would never even begin to entertain notions of actual leftism. Because anything beyond that, if this is fanatical fucking freakish leftism, then what is communism and socialism? Well, it's actual emancipation for those that are oppressed, violently so, by the capitalist, imperialist, bourgeois, status quo bosses. Got a gross ass fashy Newsmax video queued up. And trample people under your feet. Don't you know it is wrong to cheat a trying man? Don't you know it is wrong to cheat a trying man? It's called Be Careful What You Wish For with Chris Salcido. And in the thumbnail, the lower third says cancerous cancel culture. So this should be fun wrecking the shit out of. So here it is. Hold on. Gosh, we'll have to listen to that next song after this too, because it's so good. But like I said, this is from Newsmax. Video is called Be Careful What You Wish For, .. with Chris Salcido. I haven't covered a Chris Salcido video yet. I'm going to venture to say he's a fucking piece of shit. Especially when he's got here, cancerous cancel culture. So this thing that doesn't exist is now cancerous. It's like cancer. It kills people like cancer. And there's no cure for it. Like cancer, this thing that doesn't exist, cancel culture. So let's check it out, Chris Salcido.
Be careful what you wish for. We expand on old words of wisdom in tonight's preamble. I first want to address the liberal biased press. For years, okay, the Chris Salcido Show has been warning that your unfair treatment of Republicans and conservatives and your looking the other way on socialist Democrat malfeasance and treachery.
Okay, hold on. Socialist Democrat. Okay, let's be real clear. Socialists, fundamentally, day one, out the gate, are all about getting rid of capitalism. That's it. There it is. Socialism is like, yo, let's take a close look at what capitalism really is and how it actually affects, you know, the workers and the bosses and determine that, oh shit, it totally exploits everybody and it's awful. Let's get rid of it. That's socialism. Now, communists and anarchists may or may not have differing ideas on how to go about ending capitalism. Okay. But ain't no Democrat out here trying to end capitalism. So there's no such thing as a socialist Democrat.
Back to bite you.
Hold on. I'll back it up a little.
unfair treatment of Republicans and conservatives and your looking the other way on socialist Democrat malfeasance and treachery?
Like what, though? Like, okay, obviously there's no such thing as socialist Democrat malfeasance, but what malfeasance and treachery has been looked the other way on? What specifically? I mean, I can point to a lot of things that Democrats have done that have been fucking awful. Awful, awful, awful for people all over the world. But I can tell you this, every time I look at it, they did it in total congruence and concert with the Republicans. I can point to malfeasance and treachery of the Democrats, but this motherfucker ain't gonna like what I point to because the people he fucking licks the boot of are complicit in what I would point to.
Would come back to bite you. In the last election cycle, you people in the socialist press, you bashed, you lied about, and you hounded arguably the most transparent president in American history.
The socialist press. Bunch of fucking bourgeois liberal fucking pro-capitalist motherfuckers that were just grossed out. Look, man, the liberal press, which is a thing that exists, its purpose is to fucking uphold capitalist status quo, the capitalist imperialist status quo. But it does so by appeasing people who actually aren't racist. Like if you really aren't racist and you aren't sexist and you aren't homophobic and you aren't transphobic, but you know, they want to convince people within that demographic that the capitalist imperialist status quo will somehow also care about those things. Right wingers are like, no, fuck all those things. We're going to pretend that being anti-racist is racist, that being anti-transphobe is transphobic. We're going to pretend that, you know, if you support Black Lives Matter, that you hate white people, right? But the socialist press, God, there's just no such thing really. I mean, there's It's Going Down, there's lib.com, or I just said that wrong, but there's no socialist press. That's just not a thing. I mean, there's a... Anyway.
President Trump, every time I turned around, the president was talking with one of you shrubs.
Every time he turned around, the president was talking to one of you shrubs. So that makes him really transparent. So because he talked to people in the bourgeois liberal pro-capitalist media, that makes him transparent somehow. I mean, he said things on camera to bourgeois liberal pro-capitalist media outlets, but he rarely actually answered the questions they went at, like the things that they actually pressed him on, and he outright lied. The vast majority of his comments were proven to be outright lies. So I don't understand this transparency thing. Being full of shit and just talking propaganda points to a fucking bourgeois, liberal, pro-capitalist media source is not him being transparent to the socialist media.
Giving you exclusive interviews, it infuriated me. I couldn't fathom why Trump would devote so much of his valuable time to a press that committed themselves to delivering for my and Trump's political enemies, the socialists.
What socialists? Okay, look, man, you got to be real fucking clear. So all you've done is talk about liberal bourgeois media outlets and fucking and hinted at liberal politicians. You ain't mentioned a fucking socialist once because none of those people are fucking pro-capitalist. But socialists are your enemy, right? It is so convenient for them to lump liberals in with socialists because liberals will espouse pro-capitalist notions, which make them look like fucking hypocrites. And then they can go, see, socialists don't actually mean it, or they don't know what they're talking about. And since this liberal has said this thing that's contrary to what this other actual socialist may have said, Like the socialist espousing an anti-capitalist notion whilst the liberal espouses a pro-capitalist one, then they can go, see, really they don't mean it. What they're really trying to do is come and take your house and your guns and your money, and they want to fucking kill white people, and that's really what it's all about, when none of that is even remotely close to fucking reality. But it works for your average fucking suburbanite at home. The basic demographic, let's be aware, fam. This video that came out 2 days ago, January 15th, has 135,000 fucking views on it. 135,698 views. It's almost 200,000 people that are hearing that Trump is somehow transparent, and he went on all the fucking socialist media outlets, not one of them being anti-capitalist, so not one of them being socialist, and was transparent. Well, we all watch these mainstream media outlet interviews. He repeatedly lied, contradicted himself in these talks, evaded very, very basic and specific questions over and over again and routinely. None of that is fucking being transparent. But this motherfucker still wants to fucking define who enemies are.
Was a stark contrast to President Obama. Obama used the awesome power of the federal government, remember, to spy on and charge members of the alleged free press.
Yep, Obama- he fucking did. He fucking straight up did. He straight up did. There's no getting around that. Obama fucking war on whistleblowers, man. How was Trump any different? What, he said he tweeted some pro-Assange thing once or twice? What has he done? And I'm in solidarity with Snowden and I don't know, man. Let me just say this about Assange. I question any supposed leftist that's making their project all about defense of one fucking white man. However you feel about Assange, I'm more in solidarity with Chelsea Manning and with Edward Snowden than I would be with Assange. I'll just leave it at that. But what has Trump actually done except routinely scream at the press and call it the Lügenpresse? Oh, sorry. He actually used the English version, fake news, not the straight up German Nazi vernacular where he stole the phrase from. Okay, this fucking, he's trying to frame Trump as being some fucking, a dude who constantly fucking, he told people that he would fucking pay their legal bills if they attacked fucking the press and shit. People in that fucking dollar store coup on the Capitol, they fucking totally fucking brutally assault an Associated Press photographer and shit. Because it's all the socialisms and the antifas, according to the people who fucking listen to this piece of shit. Anyone that's not 100% behind Trump is the most evil thing in the world that you have to fear and fucking kill, is what this stochastic fucking terrorist is pushing. He's not coming out right and saying those words, but these are the activities and the notions that he's instilling in his listeners' minds. Fuck Obama and his war on whistleblowers. Fuck Obama for giving this fascist scumbag the talking point he just fucking barfed up. If Obama was ever a fucking friend of the left, he would never have attacked the press the way that he did, giving this piece of shit the talking point he just barfed. Obama is not my friend. He's not a socialist. He protected the capitalist and imperialist status quo. But he did it in the traditional Sock Dem liberal fashion, which was to appease people left of center into thinking that something was being done about personal freedoms, civil rights, and so on. Obama ain't my fucking ally or comrade.
after promising to be the most transparent administration in history, blah, 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 he turned out to be one of the most secretive, according to the Washington Post's media columnist, Margaret Sullivan. But as I've said before, the majority of the press are dedicated Democrats, not dedicated journalists. And now,
you know what? That's again, he's right there. The majority of the press are dedicated Democrats. I'll give him that, man. That's not socialism. That's not leftism. And it's all controlled op. It's all controlled opposition. The centrist, liberal, pro-capitalist, bourgeois press is framed by the right-wing media as being far left and fanatical and associated with actual leftists and anti-capitalist, communists, and anarchists, which it's not in any way whatsoever. And it demonizes that bourgeois, liberal, pro-capitalist media to such an extent with that, that there's people fear that centrist pro-capitalist talking point and ideology so much so that they would never even begin to entertain notions of actual leftism, because anything beyond that, if this is fanatical fucking freakish leftism, then what is communism and socialism? Well, it's actual emancipation for those that are oppressed violently so by the capitalist, imperialist, bourgeois status quo bosses.
Sullivan. But as I've said before, the majority of the press are dedicated Democrats, not dedicated journalists. And now the efforts of you people in the press have led to this.
You people in the press.
And some of my discussions have brought up media literacy because that is a part of what happened here. We're going to have
you see
to
what he out. Did. I got to stop it before we do this. And I'll even let him do it again here. It's somehow the liberal press's fault that AOC feared for her life when viewers of Newsmax tried to fucking find her and kill her in the Capitol building. Somehow that's the liberal media's fault because socialism's.
Discussions have brought up.
Blah, blah, blah. He turned out to be one of the most secretive, according to the Washington Post's media columnist, Margaret Sullivan. But as I've said before, the majority of the press are dedicated Democrats, not dedicated journalists. And now the efforts of you people in the press have led to this.
And some of my discussions have brought up media literacy because that is a part of what happened here. We're going to have to figure out how we rein in our media environment so that you can't just spew disinformation and misinformation.
Wow. Look at this.
Okay, so he's now what? Gonna go about defending the spreading of lies and misinformation? And of course he's going to frame this as fucking the fanatical leftist overreach, censorship, and attacks on free speech. When what I heard was a liberal, a barely left of center, progressive liberal, pro-capitalist, saying that something needs to be done about verifiable lies, misinformation, and unsubstantiated conspiracy theories that influence people into going and doing sporadic shit like attacking the Capitol and murdering cops and shit. Because it has a real-time effect on people. But he's going to act like her saying, hey, man, something needs to be done to curb that, that there, you know, it's some kind of fucking real Nazis coming for your free speechisms. Here we go.
Mm-hmm. The leader of the squad is now promising to rein in you folks in the press. Now, many of you will dutifully comply, willing to sell out your country and the American people so you can keep a job.
Sell out your country and the American people. All she said was something needs to be done about spreading misinformation and lies. She didn't say what. She said something needs to be done Because look, man, the bourgeois, pro-capitalist, liberal press constantly fucking parroted all these fucking, they demonize it. They said QAnon is, you know, they told the truth that they're a bunch of brainwashed bootlicking sheep who believed unsubstantiated fucking and verifiable fucking lies. But in perpetually talking about it and demonizing it, also fucking promotes it, which creates this fake division between us fucking workers, man. But again, all fucking AOC really said there was something needs to be done about spreading misinformation and lies. And then this guy says all Americans are under attack and shit. What did he actually say?
Many of you will dutifully comply, willing to sell out your country and the American people so you can keep a job.
Sell out your duty and the American people so you can keep a job. So, yeah, I mean, if you want to be a journalist, I think that you should not be spreading lies and misinformation. And if you do, it's a disservice to your viewers and the American people. It's a disservice to all people if you spread misinformation and lies. But no. This guy thinks that if you try to curb the spread of misinformation and lies, again, that's all that this pro-capitalist liberal AOC advocated for, was something needs to be done by journalists to rein in the spread of misinformation and lies. And this guy goes, wow, Americans are under attack by that. So he's literally advocating for a defense of spreading misinformation and lies. Now, why would a Newsmax fucking talking head advocate for such things? Well, leave that to you to figure out.
Spewing state-approved propaganda. Now one can hardly...
Spewing state-approved propaganda. State-approved propaganda. This is also assuming that AOC and the other 10 members of the squad have any type of real power in Washington. They don't. They're 10 people, maybe 12 people, up against about 400. And you include all the fucking, the bicameral Congress, the executive branch, and the legislative. They don't have any power over these things. State-sponsored, the state propaganda line.
Many Americans would do the same thing to protect their families, keep a roof over their head, and food on the table.
Would do what? Would spread misinformation and lies? Again, it's all she had fucking advocated for, was that journalists need to rein in the spreading of misinformation and lies. And now what? Americans what? Need to what?
Many Americans would do the same thing to protect their families, keep a roof over their head, and food on the table.
They'd spread misinformation and lies. You know, that's true. That's true. There are Americans that would spread misinformation and lies to sustain themselves. Like this motherfucker right here. Like Ben Shapiro. Like, you know, Dave Rubin. Like Prager.
Countless left-wing governments have seized control over their media using the same tactics on display by collectivists in Congress.
Okay, give me an example then. Give me an example, you journalist. That's what you would do right here. You would go, boom, here's an example, boom, here's an example, boom, here's an example. And let me make this clear for people who don't know. Three sources. Three sources to back your fucking claim. That's journalism 101, yo. Three fucking sources to back your claim. But there's countless examples of leftists. Man, I wish there was countless examples of leftists saying, hey, man, we need to rein in, you know, leftist governments reining in misinformation and lies. This is so fucking on its surface bullshit that there's no way this guy doesn't know he's telling lies. There's no way he doesn't know that what he's doing right now is making a fucking roundabout extra steps way of saying, hey, man, it's all about spreading the lies and bullshit that we tell you. And how dare you try to stop us?
But it didn't have to be this way. You people in the press could have exposed these socialists, told the truth about them when you had the chance.
What socialists? AOC is not an anti-capitalist. Even Bernie Sanders is not an anti-capitalist. So what was to be exposed? What socialists needed to be exposed? Anytime someone tells you that something needs to be exposed and they don't even know the definition of the thing they're exposing, question it, fam.
You could have lived up to the vision of the founders, what they saw when they set apart the free press, the only job articulated in the Constitution as being essential to keeping America free. But you?
But you what?
Led by men like Chris Wallace, Chuck Todd, and Chris Cuomo, you blew it.
How?
Now,
how'd they blow it specifically?
The free press will disappear in short order.
The free press will disappear in short order. This motherfucker that's got 136,000 fucking views on his video.
Centuries when free countries have fallen to collectivist thought.
Give me a break, man. This is so extreme sky is falling garbage. AOC, the clip he showed, had her saying something needs to be done to rein in the press about spreading lies and misinformation. And this guy has now literally equated that to the entire nation fucking crumbling.
The next group I want to address is the GOP. In particular, I'd like to address Liz Cheney, Adam Kissinger, Fred Upton, and the rest of you folks in the Gang of Ten who voted to impeach President Trump. In the last 48 hours, we as a nation have learned some things. For days after January 6th, the aforementioned press, even Fox News, and government officials assured Americans that BLM and Antifa were nowhere near that riot in the U.S. Capitol.
Right.
Yesterday, a Utah...
They weren't. It's been weeks. We've seen every single fucking face in that fucking building, and they were all right-wingers. They were all live-streaming. This guy is literally coming on here trying to pretend that leftists were in any way whatsoever involved with that fucking dollar store coup attempt. You see it? You see it? Even you fucking right-wing idiots. No, that was all fucking right-wingers in the Capitol. You know it. If you believe this bullshit, what the fuck is wrong with you? Rethink your life, man. Like, I'm not saying that. That's not a fucking ableist joke. Rethink your shit. Like, you have fucked your life up. If you're in a place where you actually believe that leftists were involved in that fucking dollar store coup attempt. And no diss to fucking dollar stores. I actually shop there most of the time because I'm a fucking leftist, which means I'm poor. Generally. I'm working class, man. So no diss to dollar stores. It's just still seems like an apropos way to fucking frame those people. But come on, man. None of you fucking right-wingers think that you know damn good and well there weren't no fucking BLM and anti-fascists involved in there. Show me the video of someone that kicked it off. Show me the Antifa or the BLM person that inspired them to do that. They went over there as a mob and mob attacked that fucking place. If you want to disassociate yourself as a right winger from that activity, I get that. I would want to also. But this motherfucker gonna act like they're still pushing this shit. I mean, this is what Newsmax and One American News did right out the gate. They're like, it was the Antifas and the BLMs. That's how stupid they think you people are that watch them. That's how fucking little they think of your intellectual capacity. And if you fucking then defend them and buy into it, why would you do that? While you call people cucks and shit. That's how little they fucking think of you right-wingers, man.
And John Earl Sullivan was arrested. He is an Antifa and BLM activist.
No, this guy, the Antifa BLM activist. Check it out, man. Check it out. Let me tell you this right now. Let me tell you this right fucking now. If you're a leftist right now and you're in support of BLM or you get involved in fucking anti-fascist actions and carrying the banner of Antifa and you get involved with some type of fucking act like that at the Capitol with a bunch of fascists, fuck you. Fuck you. Disassociated, disowned, get the fuck out. You are not a leftist. If you're a member of the P4P fam, you know how much I love you, fam. You know how much I fucking adore every one of you. If you go get involved in some shit like that, we're done. We're done. Have a good life. Late. Off the fucking work slack. Straight up. So I don't give a fuck what he's going to say about this person. This is one person that had loose associations. And I'm not going to get into it too deep because I don't know as much about this as other leftists do. But what I'm seeing is on Twitter are people who claim to have known him and that were always questionable and that this dude was always espousing things that made people in leftist spaces go, wait, what? And disagreed regularly with them. He was never trusted. He may have been in those spaces. But a BLM Antifa activist, he is not. And if he was, the moment he went and participated in that event, he fucking disconnected from the left. And he can go fuck himself with every other fucking piece of shit that pulled that crap up in the Capitol. Are we clear?
CNN. I wonder how many more of these Democrat militants were present on that day.
Democrat militants. He wonders how many of these Democrat militants were present that day. Okay, none. One, there's no such thing as a Democrat militant. This does not exist. Liberals. Man, even if they do embrace some type of leftist notion now and then, they're totally unreliable when the fucking shit hits the street. Wishy-washy fucking latte motherfuckers ain't militant. But this guy wonders how many there were. None. None. We have seen every single fucking face at that thing, and they're all right-wingers. The leadership of that, the people that were directing people from place to place within the building, were all live-streaming, well-known fucking right-wingers. Even if this motherfucker participated in it, which it looks like he did, it was a fucking straight-up act of anti-leftist fucking behavior. Militant Democrat. Give me a fucking break, yo.
Harridge of CBS News, one of the few remaining journalists left in America, reported that the timeline for the riot didn't exactly match up with Liz Cheney and Nancy Pelosi's impeachment narrative. Turns out, pipe bombs were placed at the DNC and RNC, and the breach of the Capitol was well underway long before President Trump finished his speech. Harridge's reporting is buttressed by...
Oh, yeah? I mean, where's your proof of that? It's not... Where's your proof of that, man? I watched that shit live as it went down with us at the P4P fam. We were watching at least a half a dozen different fucking streams. And it went the way it's fucking projected by these piece of shit fucking bougie liberal pro-capitalist motherfucker Nancy Pelosi and her people. Rally, speeches, marched on the Capitol, fucking attacked the Capitol building. It went straight up like that. Any of you that were watching it today, you fucking know it. And if you still listen to this motherfucker, then you know he's lying to you while you watch it, and you know she thinks you're stupid enough to fucking believe it.
The FBI finally admitting that they had intelligence that says the Capitol Hill riot was pre-planned. plan.
Fucking A it was.
Question. How can President Trump be responsible for inciting the riot at the Capitol when it looks like it was pre-planned and that the attack was underway long before President Trump?
Okay, it wasn't underway long before President Trump anything. But it's very simple, man. He talked to the people that fucking made this possible. Are you fucking kidding me right now? Like, how simple is that? That's why he had to make up the lie about the fucking timeline thing. To cast doubt on whether Trump could have actually been involved in the fucking planning process. Of course he was. Of course he was. Are you fucking kidding me? None of you right-wingers even think he wasn't. You know he was. You ain't gonna admit it online spaces because you don't ever want a fucking leftist to be right. come on, man. Come on. It's so easy. Trump just fucking talked to the people. You know, I got issues with it. And listen, man, I can't prove it and I don't know. But I have been asking since the day it happened is, why did they let it happen? I don't buy it that it was just the Republicans that, you know, it's mostly Republicans. But there was it's like the capitalist ruling class bosses said, yeah, we want this to happen. Why? I'll tell you why. It took me a little while to figure out why would they do that? Well, it serves one of two purposes, and both of them are very fucking good for the capitalist ruling class. If it had been successful, they could have a fascist dictatorship and they'd have their puppet, Trump, as the do-all, end-all of the law. And then they could just run their capitalist, imperialist fucking elite circles, and they could just treat us like outright full-on fucking slaves, and there'd be nobody to stop them. So that would work out well for the capitalist ruling class bosses and the elite. But it also makes it possible for what we're going to see now from the pro-capitalist bourgeois liberal wing of the capitalist ruling class bosses is there is going to be a lot of fucking police state style crackdown. I mean, it's already all there with the Patriot Act and all this other shit. All the mechanisms to completely control every aspect of our lives are already there. Homeland Security has jurisdiction over literally every facet of fucking human life. Our food, our transportation networks, our information networks, the ports, our highways, law enforcement, intelligence, all of it. But what the liberals are going to be able to do successfully is what they did under Clinton, right? So when the capitalist ruling class bosses were transitioning from sort of being in alignment with the street fascists under Bush Sr., they switched to going against them. It was Night of the Long Knives under Clinton where they, you know, started attacking far right-wing terrorist groups. It's always this back and forth. But what it does is it keeps that base of fucking unhinged, brainwashed, stochastic terrorist white-wingers hating imaginary, amorphous boogeymen. Marxism, the satanic BLMs, or whatever the fuck it is, right? It keeps them hooked. For almost 20 years, they've been talking about they're going to take my guns. Now that Biden's coming in, I'm already seeing these militia guys. We know they're going to take the guns. They knew that Obama was going to come into office and take their guns, even though he never did. You got to understand, the capitalist ruling class bosses don't care about a bunch of white people having guns, man. They're not afraid of it. They let those motherfuckers in the Capitol. If they wanted to, here's the thing, man. You hear BLM people and leftists talking about, if we tried that shit, they'd have mowed us down. They'd have shot every last one of us. That's why no one on the left, we take it as for granted. It's a foregone conclusion, and every leftist that's even spent 3 minutes in leftist spaces knows that if we ever advocated or tried some type of fucking like violent coup, especially right now with the no numbers that we have, they would just mow us down. They would just murder us. I mean, they broke into Fred Hampton's house and just murdered him in his sleep. I wish I could remember. My bad, I can't think of the comrade's name, but The dude that fucking shot a Patriot pair in self-defense, in defense of his life, they sent a hit squad out. Trump had sent a hit squad out and murdered him. We know that if we tried that, they'd shoot us all. They'd shoot us all dead. And we don't have enough guns to take on their aircraft carriers and their fucking jets and shit, man. But what these fucking fascist mobs will do, what these fucking right-wingers will do, if these fucking far-right propaganda outlets can direct them properly, is they'll fucking attack leftists and people of color and trans people, and they'll murder them. And it forces leftists that are actually really trying to emancipate poor people and oppressed people from the bonds of their fucking slavery. We have to be preoccupied with watching our back and looking out for our lives because these right wingers want to kill us. They're lusting to kill us. We get regular shit in our inbox from right wingers talking about, come to my house, you Antifa motherfucker, and see what happens. You'll get what's fucking da-da-da-da-da. I have never said, please come to my house so I can kill you and you'll see what happens. That's some fucking unhinged shit, man. But that's what Newsmax creates.
Finish speaking. Perhaps that's why Nancy Pelosi didn't include specific language used by the president that supposedly spurred the riot, because he said nothing that caused that riot. Now, we expect Pelosi and her merry band of Marxists. We expect
her merry band of Marxists.
That's what left
Marxists. Pelosi and her merry band of Marxists. And make this really fucking clear. I fucking hate Pelosi. I'm not actually a Marxist. I'm an anarchist. But I block up with Marxists, and I've studied a lot of Marx. But I'm not a Marxist. But every fucking communist and anarchist and Marxist and socialist that I know fucking despises Nancy Pelosi. And every Marxist is all about, fundamentally, day one, their whole thing is about, we have to end capitalism. That is not Nancy Pelosi.
But you wouldn't expect Liz Cheney to make such a buffoonish vote without having all the facts. Although I gotta say, whenever I think buffoon these days, Adam Kissinger's name leaps right to the top of my head.
Does it to the top of your head?
Should have waited until they had all the facts before lodging their vote of vengeance against President Trump. I don't know. Silly me. But Adam, Liz, and Fred, well, they couldn't wait to throw in with the socialists.
They couldn't wait.
So the first step is impeach and remove, which is also about ensuring that he cannot be, so that he is barred from running for public office again. The second is to expel, to expel those members who have aided and abetted and been complicit in the cruelty, the corruption, and the criminality of this administration, mm-hmm. who perpetuated the big lie. Mm-hmm.
Did you guys catch that?
I did.
Presley wants to tie every Republican to the false narrative it's looking like of the Capitol attack.
That's not at all what she said. She did not say anything about every Republican. She talked about anyone that was involved in spreading the lies that Trump did to these people that resulted in this fucking attack on the Capitol. She did not say every fucking Republican. That is fucking bullshit. She's talking about rounding up the fucking people who organized it, essentially.
As a mechanism to toss out GOP members who worked with or supported their president.
No. Who supported the president in this attack on the Capitol? That he's tried to say because he had a picture of one fucking person that had loose and very questionable ties within the leftist community, that it's all their fault. And so now what? So what that then says, this is what it instills in the viewers' minds, in the Newsmax supporters' minds, is that it's a fantasy that, you know, of course, it's actually leftists that did this thing in the Capitol. and that Nancy Pelosi knows it, and Ayanna Pressley knows it, and they're all in cahoots with the people who did it, and they did it just to remove the president. If you believe that, you made a fucking mockery of your life. I mean it. You fucked your life up. You are totally fucking detached from reality. Especially if you watched what went down, and then you, on the day of, and then you listen to this motherfucker say this, what he's saying. This dude fucking talking about, because one guy had questionable ties to BLM and Antifa, it was a leftist fucking action that Trump didn't have anything to do with. He lied about the timeline and gave no fucking example to back his claim that the commonly fucking understood timeline is somehow incorrect. That all the six or more live streams that I watched that day somehow were wrong. And that Trump couldn't have had anything to do with it because one guy. And now this guy, because Antifa and Nancy Pelosi are somehow all socialists in the same thing, even though Nancy Pelosi is a goddamn fucking bourgeois capitalist that every fucking anti-capitalist leftist can't fucking stand. But we're all in cahoots together to frame the president.
Right. Of course, criminalizing being a Republican.
No, it is not criminalizing being a Republican. It's people who did this criminal thing. Now, look, I'm not advocating to round them up and arrest them because I don't advocate for fucking police state fucking arresting people. I don't recognize the authority of fucking the American fucking police force, man, and its prison system. It has the ability to lock me up. Don't get me wrong. I get it. I'm not stupid. But it's an unjust and unfucking self-justified fucking authority. But no one is advocating for that mechanism of fucking violence to come down on every single fucking voting Republican out there. Ain't nobody who sat at home on the couch and watched this shit go down in the Capitol being targeted for anything at all whatsoever. Just the people who organized it. And anyone that was paying attention at all understands that President Trump wanted this to happen and encouraged it for fucking days and days leading up. And then what? Coincidentally, he's still the president. Look, when the National Guard, when everyone was calling for the National Guard to suppress the attack, Trump refused. And I ain't gonna fucking kiss Pence's ass for sending in the National Guard because fuck sending in the National Guard and fuck Pence. But Trump not calling in the National Guard is totally indicative of someone who planned this and wanted this to happen. It's fluid.
Cheney and Adam Kissinger and Fred Upton, well, they couldn't wait to turn over power to these lying totalitarians.
Lying totalitarians.
Don't worry, Liz. I'm sure you're going to survive the first purge after all.
The first purge.
The Democrats and CNN, they love your kind of Republican. Lastly.
You see that purity test? You see that purity test, fam? You see that? Your kind of Republican. If you don't fully, 100% fall lockstep in line with what I think, you ain't part of the team. That is some Nazi-ass fucking fascist shit right there. Deep.
Rest of the American people. You're watching an attempt by the socialists.
By the socialists.
And remove President Trump based on his inciting violence that it's turning out he didn't incite.
Based on what? Again, this motherfucker provided no source or nothing to call into question the timeline we all understood and watched unfold the day of. Nothing.
Consider this.
Some of the success that we've been able to achieve around criminal justice reform would not have happened in recent years were it not for Black Lives Matter. and the intensity and the brilliance of that movement that forced at least that there would be some counterforce to the status quo, which is so reluctant for change, if not hostile to change. They're not going to stop. They're not going to stop. And this is a movement, I'm telling you. They're not going to stop. And everyone beware, because they're not going to stop. They're not going to stop before Election Day in November, and they're not going to stop after Election Day.
Do you see what he
and
did?
That should be, everyone should take note of that on both levels, that this isn't, they're not going to let up, and they should not.
Presley or Maxine Waters or any other Democrat socialist who actually did cheer on the violence that dominated 2020, the same unfair way President Trump is being treated.
Okay, for starters, ain't nobody in the fucking Democratic Party or the bourgeois liberal establishment cheered on what was going on in the streets. They were constantly fucking placating right-wing narratives. Constantly heard things like, well, I don't support the right wings, but I also don't support the Antifa violence. And, you know, if a couple windows got broken or something, they would be like, the liberal media would be talking about fucking, we support the peaceful protesters, not the violent protesters. When, again, I have to be abundantly fucking clear, property damage is not violence, it's property damage. BLM activists and anti-fascists have not physically attacked anyone in the streets. Never. I've been in the streets so many fucking times and talked a lot of shit to cops when we were. But I have never seen an anti-fascist put their hands on a cop. Oh my God, dude, they would break their neck and shoot them 400 fucking times in the face if they tried that. We would never beat on fucking cops. One, we would never try. Two, because we're not fucking violent. Two, they would never let us. We would never get away with it the way the right wingers brutally fucking attack those people, swinging and swinging and hitting them with fucking flags and shit. You do not see the video of that from anti-fascists and from fucking pro-BLM people, man. You do not see that. You see video of people peacefully marching, cops then shooting them with tear gas and rubber bullets, declaring it a riot, and then fucking every goddamn liberal media outlet and right-wing outlet frames it as fucking riots and violent Antifa and shit. No fucking liberal media outlet was celebrating anti-fascists. Some of them kind of got on board a little bit with BLM. As long as it was BLM, they could tell how to do shit and could fucking, you know, express to them how to properly express their trauma. And if any fucking actual black person didn't live up to that fucking standard as handed down by the fucking liberal centrist pro-capitalist bourgeois media, they were shit on by that media. The left does not have a decent relationship whatsoever with the pro-capitalist liberal fucking bourgeois media. Oh, but all of a sudden now they're attacking Trump for nothing. They excused all this imaginary shit that never happened. But now when Trump actually fucking foments a fucking miserably failed fucking coup attempt that did result in people being fucking brutally beat on and cops being beat on and murdered. Somehow, you know, that's indicative of hypocrisy and an example of a socialist scourge in some way that people at home that had nothing to do with the attempt on the Capitol should be afraid of. This is so fascist 101, man.
I'm hoping we, the people, learn the lessons that the press and the 10 wayward Republicans didn't learn. I'm hoping we can all see the double standard that is in the process of being imposed on our nation. Socialists can do whatever the hell they want.
Oh, right. Socialists can do whatever they want. Socialists can do whatever they want. If we walk into the street and try to counter-demonstrate against a bunch of Proud Boys or 3%ers or Boogaloo Boys, the pigs will fucking shoot us with rubber bullets and tear gas. I've had it happen to me while we were standing there peacefully. No one had even thrown a water bottle at a cop. Nothing. They wouldn't let us anywhere near fascists. They defended fucking boogaloos and Proud Boys and shit and shot us for daring to try to speak against them, to practice our free speech in response to theirs. They shot us. We can do anything we want and get away with it. Fuck you, man. Fuck you. If anyone can get away, do whatever they want and get away with it, it's the people that fucking murdered those people and have pieces of shit like you come and act like it was somebody else who did it. And I'll say this, man. Some of those people are going to do time, but so did Hitler, man. Hitler did time after his first failed coup attempt, and guess what? He had time to write a fucking book and rethink his tactics. He didn't fuck up the next time around. Is history prologue? I don't fucking know, man. Usually it is. Just saying.
Be prosecuted, silenced, and penalized based on completely fabricated charges. The American people should learn this lesson, and they should learn it fast, because the leftists are coming for all of us. Next.
The leftists are coming for all of us.
For my wallet,
next.
I just wanted three things.
Fam.
Simple, really easy to access.
Give me
cards
a goddamn fucking break. I mean, it's just too easy, though. It's too easy, right? Like, I think the reason I do this stuff is because maybe not everybody has specific talking points and responses to all this shit. And a lot of leftists have great responses to this stuff. But I just, you know, sometimes, you know, maybe people need to go, yeah, I felt like I was crazy. Because it was so blatantly over top, the deep way with which every single word this person said was a lie, that it made me question my own sanity. Was I actually hearing what I heard? Yes. Yes, they lie that deeply. And that's always been the methodology of fascist propaganda. But I said I wanted to hear this next song from The Clash. Which I do. This is Death or Glory. And let me see, where's that? Put this up here.